Hellos, welcomes back everyone. And Fwolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as Vaedren, my agent, and we are about to go into the fourth chapter of the Knights of the Eternal Throne expansion. So, let's just throw ourselves straight back into where we left off.
Did you think to take any extinguishers when you stole the ship?
Blast! Outlander! You're up! See what you can do with this thing.
That's two more shuttles you owe me.
You didn't even own this one. It really shouldn't count.
It was mine when it crashed. It counts.
I didn't realize we were being billed for this level of service.
It's just a little game we have.
You will be reimbursed.
Of course. Never doubted it.
Anything on your sensors?
Confirmation. I have detected a large metallic object nearby. Analysis suggests a technological construct, but there are no energy readings.
Whatever it is, it's got better chances of flying than this thing. Engine's fried to a crisp.
Skytroopers won't be far behind us. We need to hide the evidence of our landing.
I'll scavenge you, Barry.
Just like Aaron Prime.
I get the sense you two have been working together for a while.
Long enough.
I know you have more questions than answers, but we should really keep moving. I promise I'll tell you everything I can as soon as we're safe.
Enthusiasm. Shall we investigate the technological object? I believe I can guide us to its location.
Very well.
Okay. We have a new companion in the form of HK-55. Interesting. Do we have any codex entry on this model? We do not. Okay, I guess we're looking for this technological object.
Did you say something, Master?
Of course, we had to crash into the middle of a swamp, didn't we? The wildlife here, the fauna, is definitely eyeing us up like a snack.
The meat bag, alone.
Okay, we have a bonus to deal with the wildlife here. If we're going to be in the swamps for a while, it may make sense to, clear out some of the hostiles here.
Die horribly. Desperation.
There are some structures here. We don't know what their purpose are, so there are, or there have been, people around here.
Protection services online. Hostile eliminated. No one harms my master. Plus one to kill counter.
I think that kill was mine, HK. We have skytroopers. I wonder if they're searching for us.
Die horribly. has achieved deadness.
Oh, this object does not appear related to what HK was detecting. Just a scrap bit of metal in the middle of a swamp.
Protection services online. Report. Dead.
More skytroopers. That was the wrong target.
Just one to kill counter.
What about this scrap here? No, but HK observes that this was a part of something bigger. Similar object here. Suggests that this was broken off of something much larger. The sample suggests that it's something or from something ancient. It's been in the swamp a good while. We have a sorcerer here.
You act more like a bodyguard than an assassin. Is that your primary function?
Confirmation. It is a very difficult task indeed, that I have kept Masters Benico and Vortena alive, despite their high-risk activities, is my greatest achievement.
The two of them seem close.
Deflection. I am not programmed to assess or discuss the emotional matters of meatbags under my protection.
It's also been 5 years. We're going to need to discuss that. Oh shit.
Stamina increase. No one harms my master. Plus one to kill counter.
Okay, giant spiders. Lovely. These aren't counting towards. Yeah, bonus we had earlier, unfortunately. I was hoping they would. Oh, you can find rancors everywhere now, can't you?
It is a great pleasure to witness your skills firsthand, Master.
Master?
Clarification. Master Benico altered my programming before we secured your release. I am to serve you with the same unexcelled loyalty with which I serve her. In fact, your survival is now my highest priority.
Escaping that prison was only my latest misadventure. You'll have your work cut out for you.
Flattery. The skills you have demonstrated thus far, coupled with the stories told by Master Benico, suggest that you are quite adept at ensuring your own survival. Enthusiasm. I look forward to eliminating any opponent foolish enough to attempt your murder regardless. resumption. Shall we continue?
We shall. So we've also been put on his bodyguard priority list.
Leave the meatbag alone. Dead. Protection services online. Target has achieved deadness.
Larger bit of scrap here.
Is this the object you picked up on your sensors?
Confirmation. Yes, Master. A closer scan suggests that this object has been here for several centuries.
The hell is that?
Centuries? Of all the junk out here, you had to find the antique.
Observation. Visible design elements do not match any from Zakuulan culture, antique or modern.
Not from Zakuul. Could it be?
He doesn't overthink things.
Haha! Do you have any idea what this is?
Thick hull. I see a few good spots for weapons. Some kind of combat frigate, I'd guess.
This is the Gravestone. This was the only ship that ever went up against the Eternal Fleet and won. Do you have any idea how long people have been looking for this thing?
And we just happened to stumble upon it.
You said this ship went up against the Eternal Fleet and won, but it's rusting in a swamp while the fleet is still around.
The fleet is even older than Valkorian, maybe even older than Zakuul. The battles happened centuries ago. Nobody knows the details of the whole war, but every story talks about the Gravestone. One ship with the firepower to take on the Eternal Fleet. This is fate. We get your Outlander. Find exactly the weapon we need. We're going to win this thing, Lana. It's destiny.
It's certainly no coincidence, but destiny? I think there's something else going on here.
Destined or not, this is an opportunity. I won't turn that down.
Let's have a look inside, huh?
Assessment. Nearby signs of animal activity suggest local predators may be using this wreck as a nesting ground. Caution is advised.
We'll split up, deal with any wildlife, then regroup to plan our next move.
Okay. It's funny how Koff was saying that we found the antique, and then all of a sudden... he's so excited to have found this ancient frigate.
Feel better?
But let's clear the place out, shall we? We haven't really got to speak to Koff just yet. All this talk of fate from Valkorian, and now destiny from Koff. I'm a bit more skeptical. Stop blowing up the ship from the inside, please. Man, it's certainly seen better days. Holes in the hull.
These creatures are hardly cunning. Their usual prey clearly doesn't offer much challenge.
Yeah! Clearing these things out? Very easy! Easiest thing ever.
Not sure if you want to go into space with this thing. There's, I say, holes in the hull. Unless we're going to be using rebreathers. The spider that normally kills me on veteran mode.
Got you covered.
Even on story mode, Koff was taking a beating. Anything worth keeping? A couple of things to disassemble. Companion gift. Meanwhile...
The Endless Swamp. After the damage you inflicted, they couldn't have made a safe landing anywhere else.
And if they didn't make a safe landing?
We'll know soon enough. Skytroopers, sweep the area. Focus on regions with high metallic sensor readings.
I oversaw security in the Carbonite prison. I humbly submit myself to answer for this failure.
Sister!
I didn't like his answer.
So, this ship has been here for 1,000 years? More?
Right. It's amazing that it's in such good condition, considering. Judging by the damage I've seen, the stories are true. Whoever built the Gravestone scuttled it themselves after the Eternal Fleet was defeated. It wasn't shot down.
The fleet was defeated, but not destroyed. Valkorian brought it back under his own control more than a century ago.
Exactly. The Eternal Fleet is totally automated. Nobody knows who first built it. and every theory is crazier than the last.
Renegades left behind after a successful droid revolution. Representatives of an entire race of droids from somewhere beyond the edge of the known galaxy.
Like I said, crazy stuff. But no matter where it came from, the Eternal Fleet is practically unstoppable. And Arcaan controls every single ship from the throne.
If Valkorian has had this unstoppable fleet for more than a century, why didn't he use it to help the Sith Empire defeat the Republic?
We can only theorize. If the war was just part of a ritual to make the Emperor truly immortal, perhaps using the fleet would have interfered somehow. Regardless, we have many other things to discuss. I owe you 5 years' worth of explanations.
And I'm gonna need some parts to get this thing moving again.
Locating supplies and fresh water would also be wise.
Let's get those parts first. Might take a while to install them.
Yeah. Ship this old? There's no telling.
Assertion. I will begin a patrol pattern to ensure that no enemy forces report our position.
Okay, the sooner we get those parts, the sooner repairs can begin. So we've learned a bit about the Eternal Fleet. An ancient and unstoppable armada, operated by sentient droids and controlled by the Eternal Throne itself. Centuries ago, the fleet nearly wiped out all of wild space. It took a colossal alien warship, the Gravestone, to deactivate the Eternal Fleet, and even it was subsequently lost in the final battle. Valkorian had heard rumors of the fleet before his arrival on Zakuul. It was the main reason he chose the planet to house his new empire. Once he had gained control over Zakuul, he began his search for the fleet in earnest, using the Scion's force visions to eventually find the dormant ships. He built the Eternal Throne to reactivate and command the lost fleet. While primarily used in military operations, the fleet is also key in collecting tributes and resources from the conquered worlds, as well as protecting the trade routes within wild space. I see. So the ships weren't necessarily destroyed by the Gravestone, they were deactivated. Despite the ship being in bad state, we do have a functioning mailbox. Rallo. Oh, this is the corporal from Darth Maul's flagship, the Republic soldier. We'd have never made it to the escape pods without your broadcast. Hope you managed to get in one too. I caught a look at the fleet that took us down. We'd never be able to take them on without you. I'm glad he made it out. And of course, Reyna Temple. No one has any answers. I thought about reaching out to Lana Beniko, but I can't risk the Sith finding out about me. Kaleo thinks your disappearance is a scheme, and I should forget about you. She's going off-grid for a while. She'll be monitoring the Holonet for any news concerning our whereabouts. And more recently, those were a few days ago. More recently. HK has intercepted some transmissions. The sudden blackout caused by the reactor shutdown has been cited as a cause of minor injuries and property damage, but zero fatalities. If we were trying to preserve life, we succeeded. It wasn't exactly what we were trying to do. We were more concerned that if we had stuck around and not dealt with the reactor could have blown up with us within the radius. And what's this? We found a control unit that could be used in a speeder bike. Interesting. We're lucky, we might be able to find the other components and reconstruct a speeder. Mine, that's a big if that we can find the rest of the components. It's not as if we have a mini-map telling us exactly where they are. But it just so happens we have found another speeder bike component, this repulsor lift. There's something in the water over there. A stabilizer. Despite being submerged in water, it's still in good working condition. Just make something out in the distance there. Another component. A gently used power core. Huh. What a coincidence to find all those components all close by to the gravestone. Could it be destiny indeed? Of course, all those components are useless. If we don't have the major frame of a speeder bike to attach them to. And funnily enough, we found one. We have now gotten the classic speeder bike. I always do like the classic speeder bike. I think this was a pre-order bonus for maybe the Rise of the Hutt Cartel for a long time, and I missed out on the opportunity. And I wanted to use it for... I might have wanted to use it for Valakar. It kind of... It suited his armor set. Well, it actually kind of suits our current armor set as well, come to think of it. That's not what I need. Vehicles. The boosted speeder bike. Now we... traveling this way. With Koff trying to locate these starship parts. It's not a rancor. Yet, I'm the stinger. Staying far away from that thing.
Feel better?
Skytroopers patrolling, looking for us. Let's try to make them not discover us, shall we? Have a juggernaut here. Grab this component. Okay. And deeper into the swamp, there are more debris readings.
Got you covered.
Crap. Skytroopers. Can we bypass them? Mind, they may have heard our shots there, unfortunately. Try not to raise the alarm. Lovely. Some form of...
It's destiny. I ditch all these parts before we crash, we find the gravestone, and then what do we need to get it flying? Honestly, it's plain as day. Not for Lana, though. For her, it's all just skill and luck and coincidence.
Relying on fate to get you out of trouble will always leave you disappointed. Better to rely on yourself.
I can't believe you two. Just wait and see. I know I'm right on this. Lana's told me about all the things you've done. More than once. Half the reason I agreed to this crazy rescue was to see if you were actually real. So, I figure I know all about your past. You deserve to know mine. I grew up on Zakuul. Served in the military. I captained a warship during Arcaan's campaign against the Core Worlds. One of the last ships without an all-droid crew. My crew and I deserted, but I'm not going to pretend we didn't do our share of damage beforehand. Just thought you should hear it from me.
Something must have happened to make you desert your post. What was it?
We were holding territory on Denon. Locals rioted and orders were to open fire until they stopped. None of us even wanted to be there. Massacring civilians? That's not how Zakuul is supposed to operate.
Thank you for being honest with me. You and your crew made the right choice.
Glad you think so. One more thing, as long as we're being honest. When you risked your life to shut that generator down, you showed me that you're someone I can count on. I want to take Arcaan down, but we don't have to take down all of Zakuul with him. I'm glad to know you understand that too.
Yes, I did it for Zakuul, exactly. It's not.
Too many innocent people have suffered already, I'm not going to add to that.
Thank you. Come on, let's get this stuff back to the gravestone.
Salutation. It is a pleasure to see you again so soon, Masters. I have encountered minimal resistance in my patrol.
Minimal?
Reassurance. Only one skytrooper and three local predators with poor survival instincts. Our position appears to be secure at this time, but I would still advise caution on your return trip, Masters.
Keep up the good work, HK.
Appreciation. It will be my pleasure to do so, Master.
The two blaster rifles he's wielding. Okay. So now we need to get ourselves back over to the gravestone. Might as well just use this quick travel item. And get Koff doing some of the repairs. Lana wanted to go find some supplies. Good old gonk droid.
Welcome back. Did you find what you were looking for?
More or less. I'll see what I can do.
Shall we, then? We won't last long without more food and water.
Let's go.
Okay. Water's more important. We can survive for a while without food. As uncomfortable as that would be, water is more essential. So we need to head out of the crash site once again. Right. Somewhere nearby, there are devices we need. Oh, actually marked on the map. Handy.
Take a breath.
When Darth Maar and I faced Valkorian, we knew right away. He was the Sith Emperor, Lana.
I know. When he was struck down, it released ripples through the Force. Everyone who had felt the Sith Emperor's presence in the past, on Zyost, on Yavin 4, we all sensed what had happened. Arcaan invaded soon after, claiming that an outlander had assassinated his father, the immortal Emperor. It didn't take long for us to unravel the truth.
Which side did Arcaan attack first?
Both. Ships from the Eternal Fleet struck at shipyards and rallying points for both sides simultaneously. They favored ambush tactics throughout the war. Zakuulan sensor technology has far greater range than our own, and their ships can fly much further on less resources. Only vessels retrofitted with Isotope 5 could manage to outrun them. None could truly compete.
So you're saying the Empire and the Republic both didn't stand a chance. The Empire may have ended up becoming the one better off, of course, since they're the ones who had the greater quantities of Isotope 5. As long as the military commanders were smart enough to, pull back those ships.
How long did the Republic and the Empire manage to hold out?
Within 3 months, the bulk of our naval forces were disabled or eliminated, and the Republic was in the same situation. With naval superiority, Arcaan's forces could begin choking off supply lines, trade, any ship travel at all. The Eternal Fleet seemed to be everywhere at once. Coruscant and Dromund Kaas were blockaded by the end of the first year.
We have that juggernaut again, Vitius. Not to be mistaken for the Sith Emperor, despite his attire as well. And his love for thrones.
How did it end?
The members of the Dark Council fought Arcaan's invasion ruthlessly and lost. The Empire's treaty was ultimately negotiated by the Minister of Logistics. Chancellor Suresh also refused to discuss surrender, but the Republic Senate managed to overrule her. A cadre of senators negotiated their own ceasefire terms. All of those senators have since been disgraced or dismissed. I'm sure you can imagine the likely culprit.
What about Sith intelligence?
I'm no longer part of the organization. But I know that most of its assets were wiped out in the fighting. From what I've heard, Empress Asena prefers to rely on technological surveillance rather than direct intervention. I'm not sure what, if any, reconstruction has taken place. So far, the treaties with Zakuul have held. But that will not last forever.
And of course, during our carbonite freezing, we had that vision of, I'm guessing, a Republic senator and a member of the Dark Council kneeling before Emperor Arcaan. The Sith, of course, though we've never met him in this playthrough, it was Darth Vaedren, certainly a member of the Dark Council. The Republic senator, I'm not entirely sure. It wasn't Supreme Chancellor Suresh, that's for sure. But as Lana mentioned, he refused to surrender. The fact that most of the Senate managed to override her is unusual. Still looking for a good source of drinkable water. God damn it. Oh, that's not in range. That's what I'm gonna give Lana a bit more support there with my ballistic shield.
A freshwater spring. It should be safe for drinking.
So the Eternal Fleet overwhelmed both the Republic and the Empire. What was the result?
Both sides are forced to pay a heavy tribute to Zakuul, mainly raw materials and resources. They're also held under an arms limitation statute. The Empire and the Republic are both breaking it, of course, but they're still incapable of challenging the throne directly.
Who rules the Empire now?
Darth Asina was the only Dark Council member left standing. All others died or disappeared in the chaos. Without opposition, she declared herself Empress of the Sith.
And the Republic?
Suresh remains in power, though she no longer holds the title of Chancellor. The Republic has limits to their ruler's terms. But her replacement is a mere puppet. Both sides see this only as an opportunity to eliminate one another at a time of weakness, instead of combining what strength they have. Arcaan does nothing to prevent violence between them, so long as their tribute is paid and no one challenges Zakuul's superiority.
I'm surprised Arcaan didn't try to destroy both governments. He obviously had the firepower.
I don't think Arcaan feels any desire to actually govern our portion of the galaxy. For now, he sees it as a backwater, useful only for resources. Powerful Zakuulan battle stations have been placed in orbit around key worlds to watch for possible uprisings. But there are no ongoing planetary occupations. The ships of the Eternal Fleet simply patrol at random, while the tribute paid to Zakuul gradually chokes all economic potential.
What about my team? My ship?
I have allies looking for them as we speak. With all of the chaos of the last few years, though, it will take time to find them all. For now, we make do with ourselves, Koth, and HK.
You obviously put a lot of thought into getting me out. Did you think about what would come after?
Of course, though I admittedly didn't plan on being stranded in this swamp. For now, let's take things one step at a time.
So why me? You clearly went to a lot of trouble to get me out of Carbonite.
Before you were captured, you accomplished things no one else dared to attempt. You changed the galaxy more than once, and if things have ever needed to change, now is the time. There is something else. I've felt it since the moment I found you in Carbonite. There's a power in you. Something new. It's elusive, but I know it's there.
I think you're right, Lana. I think the Emperor, Valkorian, is in my mind.
What?
After he died, there was a storm of energy. I barely even remember being thrown into the carbon freezing chamber. And then, while I was frozen, I saw things. Dreamed about him, about everything that happened while I was gone.
It can't be. If he were controlling you, I'd know it. I certainly saw enough of it on Zyost.
I haven't heard his voice since you revived me, but is there really any way I could know for sure that he isn't controlling me?
I suppose not. But we have to try. I believe in you. And I appreciate your honesty. I'll remain watchful for any influence he might have over you. For the time being, though, we have no choice but to proceed.
What about the others?
They wouldn't understand. And like you said, we really don't know anything for sure yet. Let's keep the matter between us for now.
Request. Please rendezvous at my current coordinates at your earliest convenience, Masters. I require assistance.
Strange. We should hurry.
What has HK discovered?
I never was much for idle chatter.
No, neither am I, really. In fact, I'm absolutely terrible at making small talk most of the time. Oh, I'm laughing in a very self-depreciating way. In fact, most of my talking is here in front of a microphone. Oh, that's sadness to talk about. Oh, hell. Oh, well. Okay, we're heading deeper into the swamp itself. Encampment of some kind, and the fire's going, which means someone's been there to tend it.
Please, save us!
HK, explain.
Protestation. I have done nothing to these pitiable meatbags, Master. They were merely bystanders when I destroyed a group of skytroopers. They've requested our help in escaping the enemy's notice.
Please, we are no danger to you. We were exiled for protesting Emperor Arcaan's war. We've already lost two of our friends. Please, is there anything you can do for us?
We're repairing a ship with room for passengers. We can get you out of here.
You're serious? That's incredible. Thank you. Thank you so much.
The path ahead of us is not a safe one. They might be better off here.
No one could be better off here.
I did consider that as well. They might be safer in the swamp than coming with us, but... suppose we had to make one choice or the other.
Hey.
Hello, HK. Back to the gravestone we go.
You're sure we can make it fly again?
She'll fly. Just been waiting for somebody to come along and remind her how.
Let's get to work then.
Well, someone's enjoying themselves. turn it on and we have the creepy whispers. Lovely. Where the hell do they come from? Coming from this way. That elevator door closed very quickly. We're gonna have to be very wary of that door. For no particular reason. What's down on the lower deck here? This place isn't as well illuminated as the upper deck. And a lot of these doors are still sealed.
I take it you have questions.